people don't know unless I tell them. They don't think of me as like the kid who had cancer. They just think of me as their friend.
There's not a handbook for this. There's not a handbook for how to get your baby through cancer when they're 9 months old.
So this
and for Kelly, she only knows the stories. She doesn't remember how surgery felt. She doesn't remember going into radiation. She doesn't remember what chemo was like. She only knows the stories. We have two very healthy kidneys that are functioning 11 years later. And to be honest, at 11 months old, that wasn't even an idea until I talked to Dr. Davidoff.
For kidney tumors, the vast majority of those are going to be Wilms tumor. But in about 5 or 6% of kids with Wilms tumor, they'll have tumors in both kidneys. The good news is that the outcome for patients with bilateral Wilms tumor is outstanding. In our experience, we've been able to save normal kidney on both sides in over 90% of the cases, whereas across the country, that number is closer to 40%.
What did he take out, sweetie? Took out, yeah, out of your belly. What was in your belly that he took out? You remember what he took out? Not only did he save her life long term, he saved her quality of life. Gave us some hope that she could be cured, and gave us some hope that her kidneys might be able to be saved. And he agreed to treat her, and the rest became history. It's an absolute miracle for us.
Yeah, give her hope and future that she wouldn't have had otherwise.
So when Kelly was about 9 months old, I was rubbing her tummy and I felt a mass in her stomach. I just knew that something was wrong. I never thought it was going to be cancer. So the oncologist was looking at this 9 month old that's laying on this stretcher in the emergency room, and she looks at me and she goes, "We believe she has bilateral Wilms tumor, which is kidney cancer. It's stage 5. And so within that first 48 hours, she had a port placed and we started chemo right away. So we did 6 weeks of chemo down in South Florida. And then the surgeon in South Florida and the surgeon in Central Florida were both gonna remove her entire left kidney and only leave her with half of her right. And nobody would answer the question of, can you live with half a kidney? Nobody would answer that question. Like, my mind was totally that we're gonna have a kidney transplant within a few years. This is gonna be her life. And then Dr. Davidoff tells me he can do something completely different.
My daughter, PJ, her diagnosis is bilateral Wilms tumor. We had a discussion with some of the local doctors, opinion they wanted to remove the whole kidney. And we didn't necessarily want to do that. We're not only trying to save PJ's life, but I'm also at the same time trying to give her the best outcome possible, the best quality of life possible.
We've reviewed the latest.
Dr. Davidoff came in. The first thing he said is, "I'm sorry that PJ is having to go through this." To me, there's no doubt he was the man for the job.
I'm comfortable and confident that we'll be able to save a good part of each kidney.
Our experience with seeing a lot of these kids and understanding that really nephron-sparing surgery can be accomplished in nearly all cases, that has given us the ability to really pursue nephron-sparing surgery aggressively for patients with bilateral Wilms tumor.
They tell you that they'll contact you each hour, roughly, and let you know how things are going. And they've been doing that. They've been keeping us updated. You know, she looks good, things are fine, everything's going according to plan, which is wonderful, and it's amazing to have that resource, to have somebody so caring that they're gonna reach out to you during that time.
So we're all done. Everything went great. Everything that looked abnormal is out. The kidneys looked great. There's a ton of normal kidney, good-looking kidney on both sides, and they look fine and good color and so on. Now you can breathe.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
What I love about St. Jude is how well they work with our local doctor. And those two got in touch with each other and they figured out the best treatment plan, the best timing. And then we came home and we started chemo back at home.
The results of the surgery are conveyed back to the treating oncologist, and when available, the pathology report is also reviewed with the treating oncologist. When the patient goes back after recovery from surgery, all the details of their care here at St. Jude is sent to the treating oncologist. That includes the operative note, the discharge summary, the pathology report, and any recommendations to the home oncologist for further treatment. We remain in contact with the family and with the treating oncologist as the child finishes their therapy, and generally we bring those children back once a year to St. Jude for specialized imaging, renal function assessment, and general follow-up.
Today we're just here for a yearly checkup at St. Jude. Our surgery was back in end of June 2013, and he was 11 months old.
A place like St. Jude with a research hospital, I mean, this is what they do. This is what they fight every day. So being able to come here, get the test done, it puts a level of ease in your mind as he's growing, that he's growing up healthy.
My husband Chris also had a Wilms tumor when he was 2.5 years old. So we were kind of on the lookout for something. We weren't expecting anything, but we were just kind of on the lookout for something abnormal with him. I mean, it's just reassuring for us to know that he's being followed very carefully.
I'm just excited to see him run around, bounce around, and play with kids. I mean, it's great, you know, after everything he's been through, to see that energy level, but whew, man, I have trouble keeping up. I think that's what everybody needs to hear. It's gonna be all right. It's gonna be a long journey, but definitely something you can get through.
This weekend was 11-year cancer-free. So that was exciting. Because beating cancer is a big thing. It's something special, and it's something that we should celebrate, being able to have a life for this many years after having cancer is just amazing.
Like, I never allowed myself to think we would get to 10 years. I never thought, like, oh, for her 10-year celebration, we'll do this. So when you put it all into perspective, I know how blessed we are. She's gonna plan a sweet 16 in a few years, and I'm gonna teach her to drive, and she's gonna graduate.
When I think of the alternative, I'm really happy to be living the lifestyle that I am, because the way that I live my life, I can ride a bike, I can do gymnastics, being able to do all those things, like pretty much do anything. If I can beat cancer, nothing can stop me from doing anything that I want to do.